Welcome back to Let's Play Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. Blind, I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're about to swab the deck, our mates. Well, actually, we have to clean up 8 cabins. One of them, which probably has our enemies inside. The ones who tried to steal the special silver dagger for our pilgrimage quest. Basri says, work hard and the food will taste better. Clean thoroughly, okay? Still not thrilled about the idea. Garten says, I'm a sailor on a traveling ship. We ride over high waves and sail across the seven seas in a breath. My lady is waiting for me. Although I fear storms a little, I'm sure I'll get through. Oh, he was singing? Jurio says, what a strange song. Yeah, I thought it sounded like I'm a sailor on a traveling ship. Yeah. Isn't there a song that starts like that? I'm a sailor on a traveling... on a traveling ship? I don't know. It just sounds vaguely familiar. Let's go visit Chris first. Isn't this Chris? Yeah. There are many plates. I think this one came from Raguna. The lead chef says, Jurio, we always keep the kitchen clean, so you don't have to do anything here. Hey, Chris. Chop chop. Chop chop. It's fun arranging food on plates. Jurio says, Chris, why is this fork in the soup? Oh, wait. Chris, can you taste this? Yes. Chris says, well, we should add more pepper. No, don't put too much. But I think it's tastier this way. Jurio says, oh, no. Chris says, do you have any objection? Jurio, you're getting in my way. Stay away. Oh, my. The crew really eat a lot, the chef says. They're also very picky. You can't relax. Doesn't it smell good? I bet you came in here because of the wonderful aroma. No, I came in here to check on you. Oh, is that so? Don't help yourself to the food, alright? Alright. You've had enough talking to them. Let's walk the plank. This is where the captain is. Let's go visit him. He's probably gonna yell at us. Oh, what's this thing? The chart of Tirasweel. This is a map of Tirasweel. It is covered with the names of countries, port locations, and sea routes. Jurio says, my house isn't on it. Hi. Jurio, you've already started working? You want to clean here too? Don't worry about cleaning the captain's quarters. I'm keeping it neat all the time. The captain must be a good example to all crew. I've just finished my ship's log entry. I wrote about you, too. If you're interested in the captain's work, I'll let you read my log. Alright, that's what this is beckoning us. Ship's log, day 1. This year's voyage is coming to an end. Soon drift ice will cover the sea. Turn back at Neri and return to Raguna, then we'll have our winter break. We have people who are a perfect company to our final journey this year. They are Jurio and Chris. Both are pilgrims. I'm sure this trip will be another success. Don't get too eager and overwork yourself. What's up? Hungry? Hungry! Feed! Kind of a waste because water-based attacks. Here, have some agility food then. It gulps down the agility food. I mean, I don't think I have to feed it, but if it's hungry, how can I just not do anything, right? Oh, is this where the This is where the ghosts were, isn't it? Or is this somewhere we have to clean? This is a way down. Does this go down also to where we have to clean? Hello? A gold brooch is shining on Mr. Heston's collar. He must be very rich. Charlton Heston? Hello? Yes? I came to clean your room. That's good. Thank you. It's all yours. Reminds me of King's Quest 3. I'm done. Thank you. All you did was clean that little spot on the wall. I should give you tips, but unfortunately, I'm out of small change. All I have is a gold brooch. No, I can't accept such an expensive gift. Thank you, though. Take the brooch.
Take it.
This room looks really clean. It's no comparison to my mansion, but sometimes simplicity is good for a change. I want the brooch. Alright, so we've begun our cleaning. This must be a vacant room. Well, I'll just clean. Well, now it looks better. That's not our enemies, I don't think. Does that say something? Hello. Logi says if I'm saying that right, I was thinking we'd be on the same ship. Are you going to work as a crew member until Neri? Good for you. Pilgrims have charitable spirits. Tess says, what a cute sailor. Please take good care of us until Neri. May I clean your room? Oh, thank you. I'll do a good job. And just clean a little spot on the wall there. There you go. Wait a minute. You have dust on your hair. Oh, thank you. Now it looks much better, Tess says. Logi says, really? I'm talking about the room. Anything else to say? Why do women like jewelry? She made me promise to buy her jewelry in Menarth. Tess says, in Menarth, they have famous gemstones made from peat. It takes many years to make them. I can't wait to see what they look like. Alright, I think that's three rooms down. Hi. Tanya? I'm not being lazy, you know. This is the break room where off-shift crew can rest. We stay here until our next shift. So you are the pilgrim boy. You may encounter a lot of dangers along the way, so be careful. But you're safe on this ship. We'll protect you. Yeah, I'm sure we'll encounter dangers. And that goes up there. Okay. Well, wait a second. I have a little bit of this ship I still want to explore. Over here? Is there anything? Oh, what's this guy? Bolto says, I like the sea. It's wide and blue. You think so too? Mira says, I can just watch the waves without getting bored. I'm glad I became a sailor, Bolto says. Okay. Alright, well, there's more stairs here. Barrels. I'm always exploring or breaking barrels, so I just had to check those out. Well, this is our room, isn't it? We must clean our room, too. Wait a minute. Something is different in the room. Maybe I remembered wrong. Yeah, everything is clean. Alright, I'm going in there last. That's our enemies there. This must be a vacant room. I'm going to make it super clean. That's it. I'm done with this room. Nothing here? Okay. I don't even know how many rooms we've done. Oh, we can't get to these stairs. Wish I could jump over stuff. Okay. I thought that barrel up there had a exclamation mark, like, over it. Alright, ready for trouble? Oh wait, you have something to say? Mind potion can't carry anymore. I feel like making like a quick save or something. Okay. Funny, it doesn't open. Excuse me, is anybody in? It's room service. Goose says, oh no, why is that boy coming here to clean? How should I know? Shirley says, I hope it doesn't peek in through the window. Is anybody in? We're in trouble. Say something. Me? Who else? Goose says, why always me? Oh, thank you, but we're taking a nap. We don't need cleaning. We'll clean by ourselves later. Alright, if you say so. That was close. Shirley says. Now that I can't see them, I get more curious. Who are they? Look through the window. Shoot! Goose says. That kid is looking in! Hide! Too late, I could see you. Strange. I can't find them in the room. I don't know what else to do, okay. Well, we can't get down there. Go in here to see if we can hear them talk again. No. I want to talk to you, but I can't. Alright, are we done cleaning? Oh, we've got a pay attention to me thingy over here. Hey, you! That bag is the most important thing to me. Could you please not touch it? But it's begging for attention. Give me the brooch. Alright, let's go up. Because I think we're done cleaning. Let's tell the captain first. But I think we have to report to what's his name over there. Can't tell him. Thank you, Bosre says. I think the meal is ready. Eat something in the break room with Chris and take the rest of the day off. I've carried meals to the other passengers already. Get a good rest, because you have an early start tomorrow. Anything different to say? No. I'm supposed to get Chris? Oh, she's not here. Chris took the food to the break room. She also got some for you, so go there and get yourself something to eat. However, I can't guarantee the taste today. must go to the crew cabin quickly, otherwise the food will get cold. Where's the break room? Well, the only thing up here is the captain's quarters. Oh, it's probably past those rooms? So I wonder what they were saying about ghosts when we tried to come in here before. Maybe that was just a joke. Ah! I think I found it. Jurio, sit down. I've been waiting for you. It's my special dish. Take time and enjoy. It tastes a lot like pepper. Tanya says the food tastes a little different today. How so? Well, you mean better than usual? No. You mean it's not good? Well, which is it? Why are you quiet? It's just that... Jurio says, don't push him too hard. I'm sure he means well. Am I right? No. Men at sea must be honest. It's not bad or good. I should say it tastes unique. Jurio says, see, Chris, it's a compliment. Good for you. No, what I mean is... Jurio thought he had to change the topic quickly. By the way, Chris, it's strange. I just went to Mr. Heston's room to clean, and he almost gave me his gold brooch because he was out of small change. I couldn't accept it, so I quickly excused myself. I don't know what rich people are thinking. How can you give away such an expensive thing like a gold brooch so easily? It's very funny. Right? Chris says, Jurio, you haven't eaten a bit. I worked so hard to make this dish. Okay, okay. You should eat it too, Chris. Of course I will. After taking a bite, the two became quiet. Munching. I'm done. I should go clean the dishes. Chris says, Jurio, wait for me in the room. Tanya says she escaped. Don't worry, she'll get better. I hope it will happen before we get to Neri. Jurio, you must be tired today. Go back to your room and sleep early. Go talk to him again. You were the sailor I talked to before. Have you ever been to Chanom? No. There's a casino in a town called Dice. Good name. One time I won 5 million piers in one night. You should try your luck if you have the chance. Typo. Okay, let's go downstairs to our cabin. And we'll go check on these two. I should say hello to our neighbors. Good evening. Oh god. He came back. Maybe we should go out and beat him up. Shirley says, no, you fool. We can't escape the ship until we get to Neri. We must buy ourselves time. Gah. They must be sleeping already. But what a chorus of snores. They do the same thing. Alright. Well, we're supposed to wait back in our room, so let's do that. I can't get in. I don't think we can sleep listening to such snores. I missed. There we go. I wonder what Chris is doing. Let's read a book until she comes back. Wow, it's about Captain Thomas. I haven't read it in a while. It's a strange-looking book. What is it? It's an adult book. What should I do? Since no one is around... Right on cue. Jurio! What are you eating? Nothing. Nothing, really. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. By the way, you must be tired, Chris. Let's sleep. All right, I'll let you off the hook. You must wake up early tomorrow, so we'd better get some sleep. Thank God. You knew that was going to happen. I walked around in the ship all day, so I had no time to feel seasick, Jurio says. It's incredible that right now we're in the middle of the ocean. Chris says all we have are mountains and Ragpick Village. Tomorrow will be another good day. Right, see you in the morning. Thus day one on the Hawk Talon ended in the twinkling of an eye. And there they're up. Next day, I guess. Jurio, let's do a good job today, too. My job today is to do the laundry and to help with the cooking. Just every day. I'll finish the laundry by lunch, so give me all your dirty clothes. Don't worry about my stuff, Jurio says. No, if you don't wash them, they'll start to smell. That's okay. You must change your undies every day. Jurio, give them to me. Oh my God! Hey, get off of me! Stop it! You must! I'll wash them myself, so leave me alone. You are so stubborn. Well, it's time for me to go clean the deck. Not until you give me your undies. Really? Oh my God. It's so hard to take care of you, Chris says. Koos says, what are they fighting over early in the morning? They're so full of energy. But look at us. Shirla says, do we have to stay in here all day again? Goose says, if I stay here any longer, I'll get seasick. What are we going to do? Bosri says, you'll clean the deck today. Okay. You're helping us a lot, Jurio. Even though it's a passenger ship, we still have a lot to do. I'll check the ship's hold, so she'll finish cleaning the deck before I come back, alright? Okay. Look at that pathing. Jurio says it's much more fun than I thought. Why exactly is it fun? Bulto says, Jurio, thank you for cleaning the deck. So the life of a sailor is not that bad, huh? He can travel across the vast blue sea. Yes, it's great. But the weather is not usually as fine as it is today. Sometimes we have storms, and other times we encounter sea monsters. Do you know a sea monster called Galga? It's bigger than a whale. If you're attacked by Galga, there's no way you can escape. Bigger than a whale? Yes, a lot bigger. Many creatures that inhabit the sea are beyond our imagination. No way! What should we do if such a big monster attacks us? Haha, don't worry. Galga is big, but it is normally a gentle creature. If we don't go near it, Galga won't attack us. Of course, if the ship goes off course and strays into Galga's lair, we'll be dead. Sailors are always risking their lives, you see? Well, leave the monster to us and keep cleaning the deck, Jurio. Okay. I wonder if this Galga is a made-up story or not. Got a heart spot over there. Oh, hey, Chris. Same thing. Jurio, I see you're working hard, too. I'm about to hang up these clothes. That much? You have a lot of work, too. How are you going to hang them? That's the problem. And here's Bosre. Arranging cargo is always hard work. Hey, Chris, are you hanging these clothes? Let me help you. Well, there's a big rope there you can hang them from. As long as you do it securely. Oh, look at that. See? That was fast, wasn't it? Thank you, Bosre. Jurio says, that's amazing. By the way, have you finished cleaning the deck? Yes, I have. Alright, now why don't you take a rest? Jurio says, I want to do more work. What can I do next? What the hell is wrong with Jurio? Are you sure? You're unlike other young kids. Why don't you ask Captain Jilba? He might have something for you. Chris, you help in the kitchen. Cook us a fantastic meal again. What do you mean by again? No problem. I'll go to the kitchen. I'll go see Captain Jilba. And Basri says, I'll continue to check the cargo. Let's get to work. Yeah! Why are we so pumped about this? Is he still singing his song? What will await us over the horizon? Here I come, Pirate Ramon. I'm the King of the Sea, Captain Thomas. What kind of song is that? Do you like it? It's called Captain Thomas's song. I know about Captain Thomas. My mother used to read me a book about Captain Thomas to me when I was small. I didn't know there was a song for the book. No, this one is written and composed by Garton. Okay. You need more food? Your pet doesn't look hungry yet. Well, I'm sorry you're in a bad mood. Now you can be bashful. Okay. I'm supposed to go talk to Captain Jill, but let's check in on Chris then. I'll cook a delicious meal today, so you work hard too, Jurio. I'll cook with Chris again today. Alright. Nothing interesting to say. Are you hungry now? Why are you doing that? An endless horizon. Now you know why we feel the Hawk Talon is our home. What's up with you now? You're in a bad mood still? Not hungry, but... Let's go see the captain. Captain Jilba! Where is he? He hasn't made today's entry yet. Our next destination, Takura, is... Here it is. It's exactly what the Sage and Dean told us. Takura's an island, so we can take another ship afterwards. Where's the captain? Check down below. Oh, I walked out. Loji says, hey, what happened, Jurio? Have you seen Captain Jilba? I just saw the captain going down the stairs. Hey, thanks. I came to see if Captain Jilba has something else he wants me to do. You just missed him. The captain went down to the ship's hold. Alright. What's his name is in here? Hey, it's locked. Nothing in here, right? I know, he's down below. Below. I have to go down another floor. I'm just checking out some of these rooms. Nothing of note. Mr. Heston gave me a glass of water, Tanya says, but my eyes still feel heavy. Captain? I think he's making his rounds on the ship. The sailor must be tired, too. I hear operating a ship requires a lot of work. Mr. Heston, have you seen Captain Jilba? No, I haven't seen him around here. Alright, let's go down. Shoot! That boy is peeking through. Hide! What are you doing? Shirley says. He can't look as long as I'm standing here. Are you gonna stay there forever? Oops. I can't try to talk to him, though. Excuse me, have you seen Captain Jilba? No, we haven't seen that stern-looking guy. No, I mean the captain. Thank you. Where is the captain? And the guests in this room are not coming out at all. Strange things happen, even on a ship. Strange? I can't see anything. That's too funny. Is this empty? I see the captain over there. So maybe we can get through to that, we can get through to here if he moves that barrel. Hello. Well, that's not the captain. That's Basre. The captain? He was just here checking to see how I was doing. You just missed him. But... the ship is big, but he must be somewhere around. Take time and do a little sightseeing while looking for him. I've already done the sightseeing. He might be down the... on whatever that next floor is. I'm gonna ask him one more time. Oh, okay. Well, we've kind of looked everywhere. I think. He's not in our room, right? First we're looking for Chris, now we're looking for Captain Jilba. Oh, that suitcase is there without the guy around. We can snag it. Oh, it's locked. But really, why would he steal a briefcase when he won't even take a gold brooch from the guy? Ask again? Looking his rounds. Oh, there he is! Captain Jilba! Jurio, what happened? Well, I finished cleaning the deck, so I came to see if you have something else for me to do. Well, that's the spirit. Garten, come here, please. Yes, Captain. Give me a report on our current course. We are being pushed southeast due to the Panan Current, but we should be back on our course once we get some afternoon wind. Thank you. Now, do you mind having Jurio take over your job? Not at all. We have already passed the Grades Reef. Jurio, go to the watch post at the bow now. From now on, watch for other ships instead of our own course. Garten, position yourself at the base of the second mast. Yes, sir. Jurio, our safety is in your hands.
Oh, boy.
We're in trouble. Yes, sir. Okay. Okay. Well, I'm going to call in an episode here, really just walking around talking to people and doing chores and stuff. Wasn't the most exciting episode, but I hope you guys enjoyed it nonetheless. Next episode will be watching at the bow for other ships. Let's hope Jurio is up to the task. Thanks so much for watching, see you next time, and always, seek adventure.